Hello, welcome to today's topic, Biomechanics MCQ for Physiotherapists, Part 1. Let's move to our first question. The plane that divides the body into right and left half is option A, frontal, option B, sagittal, option C, transverse, option D, coronal, and the answer is option B, sagittal. Moving to our second question. The scapula lies dash degree forward of the frontal plane. Option A, 10 to 20 degree. Option B, 20 to 30 degree. Option C, 30 to 40 degree. Option D, 40 to 50 degree. And the answer is option B, 20 to 30 degree. Moving to our third question. Knee flexion in prone lying is an example of option A, first order lever, option B, second order lever, option C, third order lever, option D, none of the above. And the answer is option C, third order lever. Moving to our fourth question, tightness of the tensor fascial attack causes. Option A, adduction of the hip. Option B, extension of the hip. Option C, knocking or genu valgum of the knee. Option D, plantar flexion of the ankle. And the answer is option C, knocking of the knee or genu valgum of the knee. Moving to our fifth question, nodding movement of the head is an example of dash order lever. Option A, first order lever. Option B, second order lever. Option C, third order lever. Option D, fourth order lever. And the answer is option A, first order lever. Moving to our sixth question, closed pack position of the MCP joint is metacarpophalangeal joint is option A, full extension. Option B, full abduction. Option C, full flexion. Option D, all of the above. And the answer is option C, full flexion. Extension allows movements such as abduction or adduction. Moving to our seventh question. During bending forward, the lumbar flexion is followed by option A, hip flexion. Option B, posterior pelvic tilt. Option C, anterior pelvic tilt. Option D, pelvic hike. And the answer is option C, anterior pelvic tilt. Moving to our eighth question. In high stepage gait, there is a paralysis of option A, dorsiflexors of the ankle. Option B, plantar flexors of the ankle. Option C, extensors of the knee. Option D, flexors of the hip. And the answer is option A, dorsiflexors of the ankle. Moving to our ninth question, a pathological increase of the neck shaft angle of the femur is called option A, Cops angle. Option B, Coxa vara. Option C, Coxa valga. Option D, antiversion. And the answer is option C, Coxa valga. Moving to our 10th question. In normal standing, the line of gravity passes dash the knee joint. Option A, in front of the knee joint. Option B, behind the knee joint. Option C, through the knee joint. Option D, lateral to the knee joint. And the answer is option A, in front of the knee joint. Moving to our 11th question, which assistive device allows for a 2-point, 3-point and 4-point gait pattern? Option A, straight cane. Option B, worker. Option C, cord cane. Option D, axillary crutches. And the answer is option D, axillary crutches. Moving to our 12th question, standing on the toes is an example of dash order lever. Option A, first order lever. Option B, second order lever. Option C, third order lever. Option D, fourth order lever. And the answer is option B, second order lever. Moving to our 13th question, during flexion of the knee, the tibia glides. Option A, medially. Option B, anteriorly. Option C, laterally. Option D, posteriorly. And the answer is option B, posteriorly. Moving to our 14th question, passive or active tension in the triceps surae checks. Option A, dorsiflexion. Option B, plantar flexion. Option C, inversion. Option D, eversion. And the answer is option A, dorsiflexion. Moving to our 15th question. Shear force is a force applied dash to the contracting system. Option A, perpendicular. Option B, parallel. Option C, oblique. Option D, both A and B. And the answer is option B, parallel. Moving to our 16th question. Anatomical pulleys are option A, increase the magnitude. Option B, change the direction. Option C, decrease the momentum arm. Option D, decrease the magnitude. And the answer is option B, changes the direction. Moving to our 17th question. A hypothetical point at which all the mass would be appeared to be concentrated and at which the force of the gravity act is called as option A, LOG, line of gravity. Option B, COG, center of gravity. Option C, BOS, base of support. Option D, ROM, range of motion. And the answer is option B, COG or center of gravity. Moving to our 18th question. The degree of freedom of the MCPJ of the fingers is, that's metacarpophalangeal joint is, option A, 1 degree of freedom. Option B, 2 degree of freedom. Option C, 3 degree of freedom. Option D, 4 degree of freedom. And the answer is option B, 2 degree of freedom. Moving to our 19th question. If length of patella tendon is greater than the length of patella seen in option A, patella baja. Option B, patella alta. Option C, patella neutral. Option D, none of the above. And the answer is option B, patella alta. Moving to our 20th question. In genu recurvatum, patella is option A, stable. Option B, unstable. Option C, recurring more compressive force. Option D, both A and B. And the answer is option B, unstable. Moving to our 21st question. During pronation test, the calcaneum undergoes option A, supination. Option B, pronation. Option C, abduction. Option D, adduction. And the answer is option A, supination. Moving to our 22nd question. The type of joint is the 5th metacarpal joint. Which type of joint is carpometacarpal joint? That's the question. Option A, pivot joint. Option B, plane joint. Option C, ball and socket joint. Option D, saddle joint. And the answer is option D, saddle joint. Moving to our 23rd question. Which of the following is mechanically inefficient liver system? Option A, first order liver. Option B, second order liver. Option C, third order liver. Option D, first and second order liver. And the answer is option C, third order liver. Moving to our 24th question. Tuber joint angle is important in which of the following fracture? Option A, femoral neck. Option B, trochanter. Option C, calcaneum. Option D, navicular. And the answer is option C, calcaneum. Moving to our 25th question. A therapist places a patient's knee in the resting position. This position is best described as option A, 5 degree flexion. Option B, 15 degree flexion. Option C, 25 degree flexion. Option D, complete extension. And the answer is option C, 25 degree flexion. So that's all for today. If you need clarification for any of the question, do comment in the comment box. I'll be back with part 2 of this series soon. Thank you.